let's also get an update on the situation of former Philippine President Joseph Estrada. He is still in ICU after his recovery from COVID hit a snag over the weekend. We have with us former Senator Jinggoy Estrada. Senator Jinggoy, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and good morning to all the televiewers.
All right. Kamusta na? How is your father?
Well, he's doing well since he was brought back to the ICU. The doctors have been updating me regarding his medical condition. His blood pressure has already stabilized. His kidney function has already improved. And his WBC, which rose to an alarming level of 35,000, has already been decreased. So according to the doctor, to his doctors, he might be transferred today to an ordinary room.
Oo.
The regular room, rather.
Alam ko na bisita mo na, no? You've already seen your father.
Yes.
And what was that whole experience like? Was he able to communicate with you?
Yes. When I visited him, because I was quite alarmed because his blood pressure dropped to an alarming level. So I rushed to the hospital. Anyway, the doctors allowed me to visit him because he was already at the non-COVID floor. So when I rushed to the hospital at around 1 o'clock in the morning, well, he was kind of weak agitated. So the doctors were already there. They were attending to him, especially his how to increase his blood pressure. So I talked to him and he was...
What did you say? I mean, alam mo, these situations are life and death. You know, ERAP is 84. So kumbaga, hindi biro na to ang isang elderly na tulad niya kapag nagkaroon ng COVID. Umabot ba sa emotional ang pag-uusap niyo? What was it like for you?
No, it was kind of difficult for us. Not only for me, but also for my mom and all of my siblings.
Correct.
Okay, we created a group chat among all our siblings, so for me to keep them updated.
Yes.
So it was quite hard for us because we cannot even visit him. Him being a COVID patient, nobody will allow us to visit him.
Correct.
So it's really hard for us, especially when he was intubated.
Yeah. Ngayon hindi na. He is not nasa ICU si President Erap.
Yes.
He's not intubated.
On extubate na siya few days ago. Binalik lang siya because he had this superimposed pneumonia.
Wow.
Ibig sabihin, kasi I asked the doctor what superimposed pneumonia means. So sabi niya, usually it's quite common among COVID patients. Mm-hmm. Yung COVID really makes the immune system very low.
Absolutely.
And mostly the patients are weak. So nagde-develop sila ng secondary bacterial pneumonia.
Correct.
So when that happened, the doctor advised me to or informed me that they're going to bring back my dad to the regular ICU, non-COVID ICU, for further monitoring.
All right. So I'm presuming, well, one good news is not intubated, pero may nasal cannula lang siya.
May nasal cannula pa. Tsaka meron siyang NGT tube.
Okay. Is he able to speak? I mean,
yes.
Is he is, no?
He's, yes. Definitely. He's a... ibig sabihin, minsan nadi-disorient, sometimes
of course
he can converse properly.
There are two hospitals already na binigyan ng FDA ng compassionate use for ivermectin, no less than a colleague of yours. I mean, let's face it, no, 98-year-old former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile has come out openly and has said he's in perfect health and he's taking ivermectin. I'm curious if, I think you were interviewed about this before, but
yes.
Have the doctors asked you about that, the use of that antiparasitic drug? It is given as a treatment in other countries.
Well, it
depends, yeah, I'm curious.
I have consulted the doctors of my father regarding ivermectin. because there are a lot of reports na nakakagaling na daw yung
anecdotal.
So I consulted the doctor of my dad about ivermectin. Uh-oh. And the doctor said, I will not give ivermectin to your dad because that is only for animals.
Yeah, so, but the ivermectin now is human grade.
Yes, but you know, I really have to follow the doctor's
of course.
Advice. Uh-oh. Sila yung dalubhasa eh. Siyempre, I cannot argue with them. I cannot debate with them. With
it's not a discussion in your family also, Jinggoy. Hindi daw pinag-usapan.
Among our siblings, yes.
Oh, I'm sure. Of
Among
course.
Among our siblings, yes.
Pinag-usapan nyo rin. Oo.
Yes. But one of my siblings, si Tetchi, broached the idea of giving a therapeutic medicine named Leronlimab, which is also, you have to, kailangan ng CSP, Compassionate Special Permit.
Okay.
So I consulted the doctors of my dad with regards to Leronlimab, and they talk among themselves, the doctors, the team, and they agreed to administer Leronlimab to my father.
Wait, I think that's big news. So yung Leronlimab, I'm unfamiliar with it. Let me research now. Yung Leronlimab, they applied already for compassionate use sa FDA.
Yes, yes.
Oh, Lemap. Okay, at nabigyan na.
Dalawang beses na po.
Ah, I see. And yung Leron, it's Leronlimab.
Yes, Leronlimab.
Leronlimab. And how did your sister discover Leronlimab? Oh, because it is used also in other countries as a COVID treatment.
Yes. Siguro nag-research yung kapatid ko and yung mga kaibigan niya, siguro nag-suggest. So, of course, sa akin po yung nag-update yung mga doctor. So, I have to consult the doctors also.
Oh. Okay, and it did go through controlled clinical trials, random clinical trials.
Yes.
Here, based on Newsweek. But what's interesting is it would be interesting to share the effect of Leronlimab on ERAP.
Well, I cannot share right now because there are a lot of factors. No? Marami rin mga gamot na binibigay sa aking ama aside from Leronlimab. Meron mga remdesivir, etc. Siyempre, I cannot credit kung ano yung gamot na nagpagaling sa kanya. Yung mga doktor lang na makakasagot na.
Yeah. But clearly, it's a cocktail. Eh. It's a cocktail of medicine, no?
Yes.
You know, Jinggoy, I don't mean to. I wanted to ask you lang. Has it reached a point in your family wherein you had all said, you know, we have to prepare ourselves and either talk to dad on the phone, make sure that we're able to say how much we love him, say our goodbyes, settle things. Did it reach that point already, Jinggoy?
Karen, we were thinking about it. I was always consulting the doctor.
Okay.
Sabi ng doctor, tinanong ko sa doctor, Doctora, is my dad off the hook? She wouldn't answer me. She just gave me statistics or datas. Kasi nung na-intubate ang daddy ko, we were really worried. We were on the verge of tears already. When we decided to have him intubated. Yeah. So sabi ni doctor, I will just give you data. Worldwide, pag na-intubate, only 54% of the patients survived. The rest, medyo dead.
Uh-oh.
But dun sa hospital nila, they beat the record. This hospital nila, 75% of their patients who were intubated survived. So yun na lang ang consolation ko. And I hope isa sa 75% yung tatay ko.
Oh, well, who knows, right? Miracles happen and he's clearly getting treatment.
You know, naman, my dad is a fighter.
Yeah. No, and to be fair to the family as well, you did already defend this, that when people were criticizing, bakit pag si ERAP, he immediately got a room. But you even came out and said, look, to be fair, no, he waited in the ER overnight.
I was the one together with my sister Jackie and Jude and my brother Jude who brought him to the hospital.
Yeah.
Sinakay namin siya sa ambulansya. We waited for several hours inside the ambulance for him to get a vacancy sa emergency room. When we were nung nagkaroon ng vacancy sa emergency room, we still waited for a room sa COVID floor kasi he was tested already positive.
Mm-mm.
We waited for 5 hours to get the results of the swab test. So nung nag-positive, so we still had to wait for several hours.
Yeah, and you didn't test positive despite you bringing him?
No, I had a self-imposed quarantine here. So after after a week nag-swab test ako, negative naman.
What about si Jackie and si Jude?
Si Jackie and si Jude nagpa-swab test, negative din naman.
Okay.
My sister, especially my sister Jackie, he wants to visit my dad. Sabi ko, Jack, don't visit na kasi you're always with mom. Mom is already 90 years old. Baka naman mahawa pa yan kung ano.
Okay, so my question, are you visiting your dad, Jinggoy?
Yes.
And you would be visiting him?
After our interview, to greet him a happy birthday.
Okay, all right, let's talk about...
I have a...
Can you show us?
I have a cake right now.
Oh, okay.
He's showing a happy birthday to my dad.
Well, in case people have forgotten, you're right, it is Erap's birthday today.
Today
is Erap's birthday.
Yes.
That's really touching. Okay, I'm curious. So he turns 84 today.
Today, yes.
And what are you allowed to do? When you bring the cake, I mean, if he's in ICU, I've been to ICU. Are you allowed specifically to enter or only one
relative? But he's going to be transferred today to a regular room.
Wow, I'd have to say that he is fighting, huh?
Yes, because all his vital signs are already normal. Yung kanyang oxygen flow is already normal. Wala na siya sa high flow. His blood pressure has already been stabilized. Kaya sabi ng doktora, she can be transferred to a regular room today.
Oo. Did your dad have specific requests? Wala.
Food
or I don't know.
It the other day he wanted, dalhan mo akong kare-kare. Dad.
Really? So he's eating that much?
No, he cannot.
He cannot.
He's under soft diet.
Oo.
Soft diet pa rin siya.
Oh,
so mga ruskaldo.
Okay. All right. Anything you'd like to add? So before we go, I mean, it's actually interesting. You were here on his birthday. But so he takes remdesivir and he took that new medicine that's very interesting. What's it called again?
Leronlimab.
And is he taking a Linhua? Did they give him that?
No.
They did not. Uh-oh. Because I'm sure he's taking all the others, no? Antibiotics.
Yes, all the antibiotics.
All the antibiotics necessary. And it's a part of the treatment. Anything you'd like to add, Jinggoy, before you go?
Thank you, Karen, for this opportunity. I would like to thank all those prayed, yung mga nagpakita ng pagmamahal, na nalangin para gumaling po ang aking ama. Alam ko madami ko kayo dahil hindi ko na kayo isa-isip. Nag-flood na yung aking... inbox. Sa inyo lahat, maraming salamat sa inyong pagdarasal at sana po ipatuloy niyo pa rin panalangin ang aking ama at hindi lang po ang aking ama kundi po lahat yung mga naapektuhan dito sa COVID-19. Thank you. And happy birthday, Dad.
Thank you so much, Senator Jinggoy, for joining us this morning, and please send my best to your father for him to get well soon.
I will do.
Thank you. All right. You take care too. God bless you.
God bless you.